Now we have seen the concept of conical pendulum, and in this conical pendulum, last time we have seen very important expression, velocity expression, and second is angular velocity expression. In board examination, normally question is asked, obtain expression for period of the conical pendulum. Or sometimes question is asked, in conical pendulum, period is given by the formula, and this formula is modified in four multiple choice questions. So we should know the exact formula. Let us see how to prove this period of conical pendulum. Again, we require a diagram of conical pendulum. We have drawn this diagram, so no need to draw diagram again and again. Let us see period. We have seen the concept of period in previous standard. The time required to complete one circulation, or we can say that one revolution or one vibration, it's called as period of the conical pendulum. So time required to complete one circulation, it's called as period. We have seen definition of velocity. By definition, velocity is equal to distance upon time. The standard formula is there. Or we can say that in terms of symbol, v is equal to d upon small t. In time, capital T, that means period. So distance covered, suppose body is placed here, bob is placed here. In periodic time, this body, this bob, complete one circulation. So distance covered by this bob in periodic time is the circumference. So in place of T, when I write capital T, period, at that time distance covered is circumference, that means formula twice pi r. So putting in this equation, previous equation, we get V is equal to circumference upon period. In terms of symbol, V is equal to twice pi r upon capital T. So in place of this T, I transfer this T on this side. Why? Because we want to find out expression for capital T. So T on one side and remaining all terms to different side. So we get twice pi r upon V. In place of V, we have seen in previous lecture the formula V is equal to under root R G tan theta. What is R? Radius of this circular orbit, circular path. G, gravitational acceleration. Theta, this semi-vertical angle. So we should know symbol meaning also. In examination, mention proper symbol meaning. Is equal to twice pi R, just arrangement, twice pi R divided by under root R G tan theta. We can transfer this R in the root symbol, it becomes square. So we get R square under root upon R G tan theta. So this one R and this square will be cancelled. So remaining only R. So we get under root R upon G tan theta. So we get T is equal to twice pi under root R upon G tan theta. See diagram. In diagram, there is a triangle. This triangle, and at this typical point of circle, center point of the circle, the angle is 90 degrees. So we can apply trigonometric ratios. Sin theta is equal to opposite sine, that means radius, divided by hypotenuse, that means R upon this L. So we get tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta formula. So tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta, and sin theta is equal to R upon L. So this R divided by L, we require this formula. So putting this value of tan theta in above equation, we get T is equal to twice pi under root R upon G into sin theta upon cos theta, mathematics. So we get 2 pi under root this cos theta numerator. So we get R cos theta upon G sin theta. Now in place of sin theta, from diagram we can understand that nothing but R upon L. So putting in this equation, we get T is equal to twice pi under root R cos theta divided by G into R upon L. Again L numerator, and this R and this R will be cancelled. So we get final answer as T is equal to twice pi under root L cos theta upon G. So clearly we can understand that period depends upon three factors. Number one, L, length of the pendulum. G, gravitational acceleration. And theta, that means this semi-vertical angle. Out of this, G is constant, L is constant. If theta is changed, we consider value of T changes. So in examination, normally a 3-mark question is asked, obtain expression for period and hence should have, it depends upon theta, that means say vertical angle, it is independent of mass. So in this expected is diagram, symbols, then this standard formula, and then value of V you should know, and by mathematics we can get the answer. So article finished here. Let us go further. Next point of this chapter, the concept of vertical circular motion. To understand the concept of vertical circular motion, consider a rope, and at one end a piece of stone is attached, and this rope, its other end of the rope is in the hand, and this is rotated in a vertical circle, vertical plane. So we get vertical circular motion. What do you observe here? When the body moves from A to C to B, what happens here? The speed increases. Why? Because it is moving downside, and on this body, on this stone, gravitational force acts, and therefore the speed of this body increases along the path A, C, B. So I consider when body moves along the path A, C, B, velocity changes, speed changes with increasing value. On the other end, when body moves from point B to D and D to A, so here body is moving in upward direction. So because of gravitational force, the speed, velocity decreases. So I consider along every point of this circle, velocity changes. But from point A to B, velocity increases. From point B to A, velocity decreases. So I consider in this typical path, in this typical circular motion, velocity does not remain constant. It is not uniform velocity. So I consider VCM is not equal to UCM. Vertical circular motion is not uniform circular motion. All of you understood? Next one, we will see the tension acting at upper point and tension acting at lower point. Three points are important. Here, upper point, A point is called as upper point, and point B is called as lower point, and point number C is called as middle point. In examination, normally question is asked, obtain expression for period at highest point, upper point, and also question can be asked, obtain expression for tension at lowest point, bottom point of VCM. Or question can be asked, find out the expression for difference in tension at highest point and lowest point of VCM. Let us see how to find tension.
1, 2, 3, start.
Let us see how to find tension at highest point in VCM. Again, we require a diagram. Just now we have seen this point is called as topmost point, that means highest point of VCM. So imagine the body in VCM, vertical circular motion, and we want to find out tension at point A, highest point, top point. So when the body comes here, topmost point, at highest point, then there are some forces acting on the body. Let us see what forces are acting on the body. There are two forces acting on the body. Number one, gravitational force, or we consider weight acting on the body, and this weight mg acting in vertically downward direction. Similarly, tension T around the string, there is a tension which bounds the body. So this tension is always directed toward the center of the circle. So in this case, both forces, tension and weight mg, are directed in the same direction, that means vertically downward direction. So I consider a resultant force acting on the body A at highest point will be addition of both forces, because both forces are directed in the same direction, so they are added to each other. We get weight plus tension, mg plus T. So total force is equal to mg plus T. We have seen that this body is in the circular motion, and we know that whenever body moves along the circular path, definitely a centripetal force is acting on it. So this centripetal force is responsible for circular motion. So I can say that only one force acting on the body, that means mg plus T. So this force is responsible for circular motion. So I can say that this force, resultant force, is nothing but plays role of centripetal force. So centripetal force in this case is provided by this force, total force, resultant force of these both forces, mg plus t. In other words, I consider centripetal force is equal to mg plus t. That means total force. By definition, centripetal force is given by mv square upon r. Standard formula is there, where m indicates mass of the body, v indicates velocity. That means the body which is moving at point A. We have seen that as body moves further and further, v changes, velocity changes continuously. So at this typical point, typical value v1. So we can call this as a v1. So v1 is the velocity with which the body is moving at point A. Then, so we get mv square upon r is equal to mg plus t. So we get mv square, this mg on this side, it becomes negative. So mv square upon r minus mg is equal to t. Or we can say that tension at highest point t1 is equal to mv1 square in place of v right v1 square upon r minus g. So this gives us tension at highest point in VCM. In examination question can be asked, obtain expression for tension at highest point. Next time we will see tension at bottom point, and we will see difference between two tension at highest point and lowest point. Now we stop here. Thanks.